everyone. I am Brother Eds, and welcome to another episode with me and my students. So, enjoy the video.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Brother. First of all, I would like to introduce myself. I am Maria Abby D. Candari from Grade 10 St. Vincent. I am here today to present the life of Jean-Marie de Lamennais and his contributions. Lamennais was born at Saint-Malo, in an ancient province of Brittany, on September 8, 1780. He is the son of Robert de Lamennais, a wealthy merchant who had recently received a coat of arms from the king, and his mother is Marie de Sudrais. When he was 5 years old, his mother died, and as a result, he and his younger brother were sent for an education to an uncle named Robert de Sudrais at La Chanay, an estate near Saint-Malo. During the period of revolution, the family sheltered nuns during feast who would lead mass secretly in their home in the middle of the night. Jean-Marie began to express an interest in priesthood. In October 1790, he made his first communion and received confirmation from Gabriel Courtois de Brissigny, the last bishop of Saint-Malo, who went into exile the following May. The Reign of Terror came to Brittany in December 1793. Their father Robert was arrested and barely escaped the guillotine. Soon after he had returned from exile, Bishop Courtois de Brissigny installed Lamennais as a subdeacon on September 21, 1801, at the Chapel of Ursulines in Paris. The following year, Lamennais helped the former rector of a secondary school previously run by the church, closed by the revolution, to reopen the institution, to house and revive school. He and his brother, Robert de Lamennais, purchased a former hospital. He was ordained a deacon at the Cathedral of Rennes on September 24, 1803 by Bishop Jean-Baptiste Marie de Mille, Bishop of Rennes. Lamennais was ordained a priest by de Mille on May 4, 1804 and was quickly named vicar of the diocese of the region of Saint-Malo, based at the former cathedral of the local diocese, there which had been suppressed under the recent Concordat of 1801 with the Holy See. In 1807, upon the death of the rector, the College of Saint-Malo was converted into a minor seminary, and the Lamennais brothers both joined the faculty of the school. Upon the death of Caffarelli in January 1815, Lamennais was elected as a vicar of the cathedral chapel, placing the administration of the diocese in his hands. He immediately became active in supporting the faith of the people of the diocese, supporting the re-establishment of religious communities and schools, and reforming the seminaries of the region. He led parish missions throughout the diocese. After the arrival of a new bishop for Saint-Roch in October 1819, Lamennais was appointed as Vicar General of the diocese. He was also appointed as Vicar of the Grand Almoner of France, in charge of charitable works throughout the nation. As he carried out his ministry, Lamennais became aware of a great problem of juvenile delinquency among the children of working class, especially among the Breton population, who frequently had no access to education. Jean-Marie de Lamennais was concerned about the needs of the young children in his diocese. Because of that, he sought teachers for them. He became convinced that education was a major means to combat this problem and sought to find a way to provide teachers to the rural population of the region. For this, he worked in the establishment of two religious congregations in the region. he began to recruit the young men whom he considered capable of learning and brought them into his own home and provided them a basic education. Lamine learned of the establishment of a small group of religious brothers by Abbe Gabriel de Chaise in 1767 to 1841, pastor of Auray and vicar general of the Diocese of Vannes. They agreed to cooperate, and to this end, they signed an agreement on June 6, 1819, to provide their people teachers for solid piety. With the arrival of the new bishop, Lamennais was able to direct more of his energies to this project. In response to this, the two priests began to recruit men to commit themselves to this life as part of a religious community. The first recruits received their canonical training from the brothers of the Christian schools. The community was successful and began to grow. De Chaise obtained a house in Ploermel, which became their mother house in 1824. After the death of De Chaise, Jean-Marie de Lamennais became the full-time superior of the brothers. By the time of his death in December 1860, the brothers had 852 members serving throughout France and its far-flung colonies in the world, from French Guiana to Senegal. The Brothers of Christian Instruction have expanded their service throughout the world. As early 21st century, they had schools in Europe, Africa, North and South America, and in Asia. And Pandan Bay Institute is one of their schools here in Asia. And I am proud to be part of this institution. That would be all. Thank you for listening and have a nice day.
If you like the video, give us a thumbs up, comment below, share, and subscribe. That would be all. God bless you. Bye-bye.